Hey guys, welcome to I'm Path Gaming. Today we are back with another review, Cyberpunk 2077.
Let's do this.
Cyberpunk 2077 is an open-world action-adventure story set in Night City, a megapolis obsessed with power, glamour, and body modification. You play as V, a mercenary outlaw going after one-of-a-kind implant that is key to immortality. You can customize your character's cyberware, skill set, and playstyle, and explore a vast city where the choices you make shape the story and the world around you. Cyberpunk 2077 was one of the most anticipated games of 2020. Some people loved it, some hated it. Today I will share my thoughts in this review, so let's get started. Story is the best part about Cyberpunk 2077. From the start, you can choose different life paths which lead to different interactions and choices. And as per your choices, you can see different endings of the game. Cyberpunk has beautiful city to explore, which offers dark and grim stuff that makes the Cyberpunk world interesting. In Cyberpunk, you get to see Keanu Reeves as Johnny Silverhand, who is the badass megalomaniac. He becomes the part of your struggle in the Night City. The inclusion of Johnny Silverhand makes the story interesting and appealing. Not just Johnny, the other NPC characters are well written and they are memorable.
Lights out for a minute.
The side quests as well as the main missions are interesting, and the variety makes you glued to the game for hours. The best thing is each mission can be completed either by the stealth approach or by going Rambo.
You like that?
The vehicles in the game are pretty cool, but you can't just steal a random vehicle and make it yours. You'll have to buy most of them. Now talking about the things that I didn't like, besides the release issues, there were few things that I believe could have been better. The NPC AI is not that good. Most of the time, NPCs will get scared of you and run away. There isn't enough variety in their behavior. The lack of unique interactions make the NPC interaction pointless. When it comes to fighting different enemies, most of the time enemies feel like bullet sponges, which gets annoying after a while. One other thing that felt missing was character customization after the initial setup, the absence of which was a little disappointing. So my last thoughts on Cyberpunk 2077 are: the story, gameplay, missions all make it worth playing, and if you are interested in playing, wait for a few more months for new patches, then only you can truly experience and enjoy the Night City. That's all for today guys, hit that like button if you enjoyed the video and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.
Brain first!